Hello and welcome to The Big Vote, where we bring you all the election updates of the day in our special bulletin. And first up today, even as the elections are underway and the big day is drawing closer, Narendra Modi has decided to take the battle on a personal level. Here's what he said today.
Political hostility at an all-time high. While the country is celebrating democracy's biggest festival, the fight between political parties to reign supreme at the center is heating up. And with that, the hostility between politicos is also elevating by the day. Political bigwigs are often locking horns this poll season, taking a dig at each other amidst all the hostility. Modi ups the ante. From his famous Shahzada pot shot to the most recent RSVP model dig, BJP's PM candidate has time and again attacked the Congress with his quick wit and sarcastic oratory skills. In the heat of the ongoing LS polls, Modi's attacks have just gotten sharper. Modi tears into Congress in UP. Addressing his Bharat Vijay rally at Hardoi in UP, an aggressive Modi seemed like he spared none. Raking up the tea-seller jibe of the Congress, Modi launched a scathing counter-attack. Taking the cue from there, Narendra Modi further trained his guns on the Congress's first family with the Damad jibe. And Rahul certainly had to feature in his attack.
हमारे जो राहुल भैया है ना वो गरीबी को देखने के लिए जाते हैं ये सोने का चम्मच लेकर के पैदा हुए हैं तो उनको गरीबी को देखने के लिए जाना पड़ता है उनके लिए गरीब ये टूरिस्ट डेस्टिनेशन होता है और फिर अच्छी फोटो निकले इसलिए गरीब के बच्चे को गोद लेकर के फोटो निकाल देते हैं
After the Hardoi rally, Modi addressed another gathering in Etah. There too, he left no stone unturned in hitting out at the Congress top brass.
ये माँ बेटे की सरकार आपके आंख में ऐसे दूर झांक रही है, ऐसे दूर झांक रही है। 2009 में ये माँ बेटे ने वादा किया था। कि दिल्ली में उनकी सरकार बनेगी तो 10 करोड़ नौजवानों को रोजगार मिलेगा मैं जरा पूछना चाहता हूं ये मां बेटे ने वादा किया था आपको रोजगार देने का आपको रोजगार मिला है
मोदी फ्लॉन्टेड हिज ऑरेटरी स्किल्स इन एटा आफ्टर रिपीटेड डिग्स एट द गांधी नेहरू फैमिली ही डिड नॉट स्पेयर द एसपी एंड द बीएसपी ईदर
ये आंधी सुनामी में बदल गई है भाई अब सबका बचना मुश्किल है सबका मतलब तो यानी सपा तो यानी बसपा का यानी कांग्रेस सबका बचना मुश्किल है
The BJP PM candidate is raising the hostility bar like never before. Even as Modi has made the poll a personal fight, Congress's first family is yet to rebut to Modi's sarcastic remarks. While political debates are good for democracy, personal attacks such as this might not be healthy for the country. So, will the personal jibes come to an end sooner or later? Only time will tell. News 9 report.
While Narendra Modi tried to embarrass the Gandhi family, there was some embarrassment in store for the BJP prime ministerial candidate himself. One of the prominent families of Varanasi have refused to propose his candidature in the constituency. Take a look.
No shehnai for Modi's Varanasi dream. Narendra Modi's Varanasi dream seemed to have taken a beating even before the BJP's PM candidate files his nomination. In a bid to boost Modi's prospects in Varanasi, the BJP had approached the family members of late Shehnai Maestro Bismillah to support the party's prime ministerial candidate. The kin of the famed musician, though, refused the offer to be Modi's proposer, even as Varanasi has turned into a hotbed of Lok Sabha polls. Bismillah Khan's son, Zameen Hussain Bismillah, confirmed the same. He further added that their family is a family of musicians and that they have never been into politics.
बीजेपी के लीडर का फोन आया हमारे पास, नाम नहीं लेंगे, तो उनका नहीं प्रस्तावक बनना है, बीजेपी का प्रस्तावक बनना है, नाम नहीं लेंगे, तो हमको आखिर प्रस्तावक क्या होता है हम तो नहीं जानते, इस बारे में कोई राजनीति में है नहीं, जब हमारे अब्बा हुजूर नहीं थे ये राजनीति में, हम लोग हमारे अब्बा हुजूर संगीत में थे, आज भी संगीत में उनके बेटे हैं हम लोग, तो वहां लिख के दे दिया था कि प्रस्तावक हम लोग नहीं बनेंगे, ऐसा हम तो हम लोग वोटर हैं, वोटर वोट देते हैं।
जमीन हुसैन सेड दैट इट वाज देयर विश वेदर और नॉट टू सपोर्ट मोदी एंड दैट दे डिड नॉट वांट टू डिसअपॉइंट देयर पॉलिटिकल फादर।
क्यों नहीं प्रस्ताव बनना चाह रहे हैं, ये हमारी मर्जी है, हमारे अब्बा जब नहीं किसी भी पार्टी के प्रस्तावक नहीं लिया तो हम कैसे लेंगे, अपने अब्बा को नाराज करें, जिस्म मर जाता है रूह नहीं मरती है, आत्मा नहीं मरती है, इसलिए हमारे अब्बा हमारे साथ में बैठे हुए हैं, वो देख रहे हैं, सुन रहे हैं।
Bharat Ratna Bismillah Khan's name has remained engraved in the history of the culturally vibrant Varanasi. But the BJP's attempt to cash in on votes with the Bismillah's backing has been foiled. Muslim clerics welcome the decision. Muslim clerics have expressed their happiness over Bismillah Khan's family refusing to support Modi. Mufti Mukarram, the Imam of Fatehpur Mosque, justified the action of the kin of the late Ustad.
देखिए बिस्मिल्लाह खान परिवार का ये एक्शन बिल्कुल सही है और जिसका जो काम है उसी को करना चाहिए, राजनीति जिनका काम है उन्हीं को करना चाहिए, और हमारा भी मानना यह है कि राजनीति को साफ सुथरा होने की जरूरत है। जब आदमी की अपना पर्सनैलिटी ऐसी नहीं है, जब आदमी की अपनी पर्सनैलिटी ऐसी नहीं है तो किसी की अपील करने से या प्रोपेगेंडा करने से कोई जीत नहीं सकता और नरेंद्र मोदी को कोई पसंद नहीं करता।
खालोद रशीद फिरंगी महाली, अ मुस्लिम क्लेरिक, रिग्ड अप मोदी स्टांस ड्यूरिंग द गोधरा रायट्स एंड सेड दैट कुड बी द रीजन फॉर द रिजेक्शन।
नो, आई वेलकम द स्टैंड टेकन बाय द फैमिली ऑफ द बिस्मिल्लाह खान टू नॉट टू अटेंड द नॉमिनेशन सेरेमनी ऑफ मिस्टर मोदी। द इमेज ऑफ मोदी एज फार एज मुस्लिम कम्युनिटी इज कंसर्न, एज फार एज सेक्युलरिज्म इज कंसर्न, एज फार एज स्टैंड इन 2002 राइट इज कंसर्न, all these issues are the basic issues I think which must be in the mind of the family of the Bismillah Khan when they have refused to attend his nomination ceremony.
While Muslim clerics took turns to back the decision of Bismillah's family, the rejection has had its impact even in the political circles. Congress leaders also welcomed the decision, justifying it to be right. They further said that Modi should evaluate his image amongst Muslims following the rejection.
किसी को भी यह हक है, वो चाहते थे उन्होंने मना कर दिया, इससे अंदाजा कर लेना चाहिए मोदी जी को कि मुसलमान उनसे कितना प्यार करेंगे।
देखिए वो फैमिली एक देश की बड़ी नामी गिरामी फैमिली है, बहुत सेकुलर फैमिली है, ये उनका अपना फैसला है और उन्होंने ठीक कहा, वो कभी सियासत में नहीं रहे तो वो क्यों उनके के प्रपोजर बने, इसमें मुझे कोई हर्ज नजर नहीं आता और शायद उन्होंने सही कदम उठाया।
JDU लीडर KC त्यागी यूज द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू टेक अ डिग एट नरेंद्र मोदी।
कोई भी स्वाभिमानी आदमी श्री नरेंद्र मोदी का प्रस्तावक बनना पसंद नहीं करेगा।
PT चन्नूलाल मिश्रा कम्स टू मोदीज रेस्क्यू। A day after Ustad Bismillah's family refused to propose Modi's candidature, Hindustani classical singer Pandit Channulal Mishra has said that he will serve as Modi's proposer.
शुक्रवार को हमको सूचना मिली, मेयर साहब आए, मोदी जी ने मेयर साहब से कहा कि हम चाहते हैं कि पंडित जी एक प्रतिष्ठित व्यक्ति हैं और मैं उनका सम्मान करता हूं, मैं चाहता हूं कि वो हमारा वो प्रस्तावक बने, तो मैंने कहा भाई ठीक है, वो जो हमको पहले बुलाएगा और जो हमारा सम्मानित कर रहा है, जो बुला रहा है, तो उसको हम जरूर करेंगे, इसमें कोई बात नहीं है, लेकिन हमारी इच्छा है कि मोदी जी आगे बढ़ें और मोदी को भी चांस मिलना चाहिए। उन्होंने मुझे याद किया है और आदर पूर्वक उन्होंने हमको बुलाया है, तो हमने स्वीकृति दिया है कि ठीक है, जब कागज आप भेजेंगे तो हम आपको दे देंगे।
पंडित चन्नू लाल फर्दर सेड दैट ही इज एन आर्टिस्ट एंड दैट इफ सोनिया गांधी, मुलायम सिंह यादव वुड हैव आस्क्ड, ही वुड हैव सपोर्टेड देम टू। ऑल्दो मोदीज वाराणसी ड्रीम्स हैज गॉट चन्नू लाल मिश्रा'स बैकिंग, द रिजेक्शन ऑफ बिस्मिल्लाह'स फैमिली इज डेफिनेटली नॉट गुड न्यूज फॉर द सैफरन पार्टी। With Modi locking horns with the AAP chief Arvind Kejriwal and Congress local face Ajay Rai, a stiff battle in Varanasi is certainly on the cards. Who among the three players will make it big despite the challenges remains to be seen. A News 9 report.
Well, it was a historical day of sorts for the BJP as well as the Shiv Sena, as Narendra Modi and Uddhav Thackeray shared the dais for the very first time. Well, at a jam-packed rally at Kalyan, which was jointly hosted by the BJP and Shiv Sena, Modi said that the mother-son duo of Sonia Gandhi and Rahul Gandhi had assumed hoodwinking the Indian public was their birthright. The Gujarat CM also noted that the UPA's grandiose plans of making India slum-free had remained only on paper. Well, Modi began his speech at Kalyan comparing arithmetic with chemistry, and now he has lashed out at the ruling Congress and the UPA for gross misgovernance in the country. This particular meeting and this particular incident of the two leaders sharing the dais gains significance, as it had been widely reported that the Shiv Sena was miffed with the Bharatiya Janata Party, as the latter had attempted to join hands with the MNS as well, and this had not gone down too well with the Shiv Sena. But now, with the two leaders sharing the dais, and after the Shiv Sena had on a couple of occasions criticized Modi as well and had sided LK Advani, now it seems like the olive branch has finally been extended. And meanwhile, looks like the hardliner right-wing groups are proving to be quite a handful for the BJP prime ministerial candidate. Even as Narendra Modi is trying desperately to put up a secular image, the threats and the polarization that has been put forth by these right-wing groups is proving to be too much for him to handle. Take a look.
It's nice to get all the help and support to form the Sarkar. But Modi's so-called friends, who are trying to help him come to power, are proving to be nothing less than enemies. Sharp criticism doesn't affect Giriraj. Bihar BJP leader Giriraj Singh came out with an obnoxious attack on Modi's non-supporters. He wanted them to be sent to neighboring Pakistan. Today, an FIR was filed against the BJP leader by Jharkhand police. But looks like this hasn't affected the Modi fan one bit. He remained unfazed and stood by his controversial comment that has been condemned by rival parties.
I stand by my statement that those trying their best to stop Modi from coming to power have no place in India and should go to Pakistan, whose interests these Modi baiters have sought to espouse by opposing him in the polls.
Meanwhile, in a hope to form Modi Sarkar, if they get absolute majority, the BJP was seen distancing itself from Giriraj's violent explosion in haste. Instead of pushing Giriraj away from the party, the Saffron Party was seen meekly moving itself away from him. No wonder such hardliners still remain unapologetic about their remarks and behavior.